Bonjour, bienvenue. Parlez-vous français? Well, I'm talking a little bit like Fancy Nancy because today we're going to talk about Paris and the Olympics. And I'm so excited to share these things with you. I have my beret on, which is very French, très chic. And I have some stories that take place in Paris. Like Madeleine, and you see the Eiffel Tower. That's a very important part of Paris. I just love Paris. It's so beautiful. And I'm sitting at a cafe, which you might find in Paris all over the place. Here's Fancy Nancy and the Late Late Night. She speaks French a lot. There's a lot of words that she says that are French. Just like I was trying to do, but I don't really speak French. I know a few words, like bonjour. Can you say bonjour? That means hi, hello. And bienvenue is welcome. Welcome to my cafe. Here's another one that says Madeleine says merci. Merci means thank you. So now we learned three French words today. Well, I'm also going to share with you a little bit about the Eiffel Tower and the Olympics. Go Team USA! I'm going to talk to you today about some of the things that we see in the Olympics. There are so many athletes that practice so hard to come here, and it happens every 4 years, but it's held in a different place every 4 years. So today we're going to talk about Paris and the activities that you might see if you were attending the Paris Olympics. I think I can see the Eiffel Tower from here. Oh, so exciting. Well, we're going to play a little game. And this is to help you realize what might be some of the competitions that we're going to see in the Olympic Games. So I'm going to show you some pictures or some objects, and you need to think and say which one you don't think is going to be in the Olympics. Let's take a look at what we have here. I have a basketball, a baseball, a table tennis ball, and a soccer ball. Which one do you think does not happen at the Olympics? That's a tough one. If you guessed baseball, you are right. Baseball is not in the Olympics, but we do have basketball, table tennis, and soccer. What do we use with a baseball? Well, we also need a bat, so they go together. What do we need with a basketball? A hoop, and usually a net. What do we need with a soccer ball? We need our feet and the goalposts because there's a lot of running with a soccer ball. And what do we use for table tennis? Well, table tennis is a very light ball. Now, you can't feel this, so you're not quite sure how it is. But if you've ever played table tennis, you're going to use a paddle, hit the ball, and it's on a table. That's why they call it table tennis. So there are paddles and you hit the ball back and forth on the table with a little net in the middle. What else do we think might be at the Olympics? Let me show you these pictures. I'm gonna start with this one. There's someone rowing. Row, row, row his boat. Then we have a car. Car racing, is that in the Olympics? And then we have sailing. Which one of those would you say is not in the Olympics? It would be this one right here. Racing a car does not happen in the Olympics, but there is rowing, and you use the oar to go in the boat, and there is sailing in the Olympics. I have one more set for you. Let's see what we've got here. We have a roller skater, a cyclist, and a golf. And that just happens to be Mickey Mouse with his golf. Which one is not in the Olympics? Why, it is roller skating. Now, in the Winter Olympics, we have ice skating, which happens on the ice. But those are the two things that are in the Olympics. We have cycling, and they go on a track, or they go into the hills. When they're cycling, it's mostly going around the roads. And golf. Well, what do you need for golf? You need a golf club and a golf ball. And what do you do with a golf ball? Well, you try to hit it, and it will go into the hole. If you get it into the hole, it's a hole in one. So that is golf, and that is basketball, and that is cycling. So there's so many sports that happen in the Olympics. What else? Let me show you the next one I have. Oh, this one's a hard one to get. I have archery. You need a bow, and you need an arrow, and you put it on here like this, and you have to have a target. It's not as easy as you think. You pull back, and it's lighting up. Let it go. I didn't want to do it, so I don't want to hit anybody or anything. But what you try to do is you try to hit a target. And that is archery. What else do I have? I have a pool table. Is a pool table in the Olympics? Let's think. I also have this is badminton. You can just hit this and you try to hit it over a net. Lots of things that we hit, and lots of things with nets. So this is badminton. And swimming. Here comes my swimmer. Which one is not in the Olympics? Well, we do have badminton. That's in. We definitely have swimming. That's in. We do have archery. That's in, but which one don't we have? Why, it would be pool. We do not have pool in the Olympics. Who knows what the future has in store? Maybe it will be there someday. Let's see, I have more. This is a racket. It is a badminton racket, but we're going to put this ball with it. And if it were thicker, means fatter, thicker, and a more sturdy racket, we could play a game called tennis. This is a tennis ball. Is tennis in the Olympics? Well, let's see what else I have. And I have a stick, which this stick should look a little more like the end of an umbrella, and you hit the ball for field hockey. And football. Oh, that's a tricky one. So we have tennis. With the tennis. Yes, we do have tennis. And then the stick and the ball. Field hockey, we do have that. And football. Now, football is not in the Olympics, but some places call soccer football. So you might hear people talking about football, and they are talking about this kind of football because you use your feet to hit the ball with that. And this, well, I'm sure you've seen this on a Sunday or a Saturday on the weekend, because football is very popular in the United States of America. So football is not the one that's in the Olympics, and who knows if that will ever come there. But the football that is soccer is. There is another sport that is very similar to football, and it's called rugby. And the ball's a little different. It's a little bit different shape, but it's long. It's not round, it's long. So rugby, you can tackle, but they don't wear helmets and shoulder pads like we do in our football games in the United States. And rugby is in the Olympics as well. We have another one. And I have horses here. Horses are for equestrian things, riding horses, doing tricks with the horses, jumping the horses. And then we have skiing. Oop, they're falling over. And horses don't want to stay up. We have skateboarding. Ooh. And I have a pistol right here. Now, this is a pretend pistol. I would not have the real one here because I don't want to get hurt, and I don't want anybody around me to get hurt. So I have a pretend pistol. And would they be shooting in the Olympics? Don't point a gun. If you see a gun lying around, don't touch it. Which one of these things would not be in the Olympics? That's a tricky one. Well, if you pick skiing, skiing is not in the Olympics. Not the Summer Olympics, it's in the Winter Olympics, because in the Summer Olympics, like they have in Paris, there's no snow, so you can't have that. And there is shooting. There's different kinds of shooting. There's pistol shooting, there is rifle shooting, and there's skeet shooting. Skeet shooting is when there is a little clay object, they throw it up in the air and they try to shoot it and get it. And there is skateboarding in the Olympics. I was watching that just the other day on TV. They take the skateboard and they do tricks and flips, and maybe you do that at your home. Well, maybe you're too little, but maybe somebody in your family does. So that is that. I have one more set of things to show you, and then I want to read you a story. I have weightlifting. or darts? Which one does not go in the Olympics? It is darts. We do have weightlifting in the Olympics, but they lift a lot heavier stuff than what I'm lifting. So there you have some of the things, and the list is even longer, that are in the Olympics. I thought today I would read you a story about one of my favorite things in the Olympics. And this is a story about Simone Biles. She has won so many gold medals by performing in the Olympics, and she is a gymnast. Now you do dancing and kicks and spins and flips, and you do it on a beam, which is about that big sometimes, or there's floor exercises where you do more of the dancing, but you still do flips, and you do things on bars and do flips. I couldn't do that. But Simone Biles is wonderful. So today I'm going to read you the story about her by Jana Brownwood, illustrated by Kim Holt. Simone Adrian Biles was born on March 14, 1997 in Columbus, Ohio. She lived with her mother and two older siblings, Ashley and Teven. When she was 2 years old, her little sister Adria was born. Unfortunately, her mother couldn't care for them. After some time in a foster home, Simone's older siblings went to live with their great aunt. Simone and Adria were adopted by their grandparents, Ronald and Nellie. They raised the girls in Spring, Texas, as if they were their own children. Simone's parents noticed that she had a lot of energy and very little fear. She would do flips and tumbles around the house in the backyard and even off of the mailbox. Doctors diagnosed Simone with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, ADHD. That explained why she was so physically active and often had a hard time focusing. But she sure could focus when she's doing her gymnastics. Look at her go, flipping around. Wow, that's beautiful. When Simone was 6 years old, she went on a field trip to a gymnastics center. While she was there, Simone copied the moves of the gymnasts. Her natural talent caught the eye of a coach who asked Simone parents to sign her up for gymnastic classes, and they did. There you can see they're on the balance beam. When she was 13, Simone started homeschooling. This allowed her to learn and study while sticking to her busy training schedule. At 14, Simone tried for a spot on the United States women's national gymnastic team. She just missed making it, but she didn't give up. She worked even harder and made the team the very next year. In 2013, at the age of 16, Simone became the first African-American to win the world all-around title. Yay! She went on to win that title in 2014 and 2015 as well, making her the first female gymnast to win the world all-around title 3 years in a row. Uno, dos, tres. Un, deux, trois, 3 years in a row. What did Simone do next? Well, I don't know. What did she do next? She went to the Olympics! Woohoo! Simone competed in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil in 2016 and made Olympic history by becoming the first U.S. gymnast to win 4 gold medals. She also won 1 bronze, and she was named the Olympic all-around champion. Simone was the smallest U.S. Olympian at the Rio Games, but her amazing performance was big news. Team USA chose her to carry the American flag at the closing ceremony. The flag towered over the 4-foot-8-inch Olympian, but she carried it with grace and pride. Afterward, Simone and her teammates traveled around the U.S. doing gymnastic routines in front of sold-out crowds. They performed in more than 30 states and met lots of adoring fans. Not only has Simone performed difficult moves, but she has also created new ones. Yes, and I was just watching the other day, and they might even name a move after her. That's pretty special. But she has also created new ones, as I said, and there are 4 moves named after her. 2 for the floor, 1 for the balance beam, and 1 for the vault. She is pretty good. Not pretty good, she's very good. To watch her perform. It takes a lot of discipline to become a worldwide, world-class gymnast like Simone. In addition to the long hours of practicing and exercising, Simone makes sure to eat healthy foods every day. But after a competition, she treats herself to pepperoni pizza. When Simone does take a break from training, she loves to shop, hang out with her friends, play games with her family, and travel. Her favorite place to go is Belize. I've never been there. I'm sure it's beautiful. Simone has faced some hard times during her career. She has spoken out about abuse she experienced at the hands of a doctor who worked with the U.S. Women's National Gymnastic Team. He didn't always do what he was supposed to. At the 2018 U.S. Gymnastic Championships, where she won her 5th all-around title, Simone wore a teal leotard to show her support for all those who had been abused. In 2019, while Simone was training for the next Olympics, a global pandemic broke out. Because so many people were getting sick with the COVID-19 virus, the 2020 Olympics were postponed. This was upsetting for many of the athletes. They had worked so hard to be ready to compete. In the 2020 Olympic game, when the 2020 Olympic Games finally took place in 2021 in Tokyo, Japan, Simone was expected to be in 6 events, but she decided to compete in just 1. Wow, I guess she was listening to her body. Maybe she was having troubles, and that's okay. Fans around the world were shocked and disappointed, but Simone was brave for listening to her body. She knew she had to take care of herself. Mental health comes first, she said. That's more important than any other medal you could win. Simone stayed in Tokyo and cheered her teammates on. Woohoo! Go Team USA! In the end, she won the bronze medal in the balance beam event and a silver team medal. Simone is considered to be the greatest gymnast of all time. She has won more Olympic and world championship medals than any other gymnast. She has spoken courageously about ADHD, stopping abuse, and the importance of mental health. And in 2022, President Biden awarded her the Presidential Medal of Freedom. Simone Biles is a perfect example that powerful things can come in small packages. And I can say that in the 2024 Paris Olympics, Team USA's gymnastic team won a gold medal! Yay! Team USA! With Simone Biles anchoring that team. Well, I don't know if you'll get to watch any of the Olympics, but if you can catch Simone Biles in any of those, it's worth watching. All the athletes are so good because they all train so hard, and it's grueling sometimes, but they do a wonderful job, and I'm so proud to call them Team USA. I hope you've enjoyed learning a little bit about Simone and some of the activities that happen at the Olympics. So until next time, au revoir, goodbye.